Alright, this is what I was able to get my hands on this weekend. It's a Exmark 30-inch commercial machine. If you're not familiar with it, it is a Kawasaki motor, two-blade machine, cones, bag, mulch, or side discharge, which is actually pretty nice. If you look at the next comparable machine, the 32-inch commercial walk behind, bag's going to run you another $400, mulch kit. I forget off the top of my head, but it's not going to be cheap, I can guarantee you that. This thing isn't going to be able to pull a bell key, anything like that. It's not really a replacement for a commercial walk behind. It's not going to be able to do as much. Kind of a hard target to hit if you're in a commercial mowing business. This isn't a necessary piece of equipment. It's just one of those things that's nice to have in certain occasions. Big thing being, you got small yards or customers. We don't want big stuff on the lawn. Easy to rut, kind of moist days. This thing will definitely come in handy. Doesn't take up a whole lot of room on the trailer. Real easy to work with. Engine sips fuel with a gallon fuel tank. You can run just about all day with it. But yeah, one of the complaints is it's underpowered. I actually got it, and when it was nice yesterday, went out and mowed with it. So I'll have that video here after this. But pretty tall grass. First, I mulched, bagged, side discharged, taken down to 3.5 inches, and then to really see what it would do and how it would handle, I dropped it down all the way to 1.5 inches and some wet, thick stuff. This is February, it's been sitting for a while. And it's definitely bogged down in some areas, but overall I was pretty impressed. After reading about it, I wasn't expecting her to do so well, but she held her own. Like I said, it's not gonna be a replacement for a commercial walk behind. It'll just tear through anything. If you got vacant lots or foreclosed homes you're working with, I wouldn't probably take this in there. But definitely a nice machine, and for the price, I'd often say for the $1,100 more, you can go with a commercial walk behind. But that being said, as I mentioned, you get the mulch kit and bag around here that are included in the price. Most people are going to compare this to the Toro 30-inch. Definitely a more robust machine. This will last longer, especially on the residential model. That thing. If you're a commercial guy, don't buy it. Right? If you're a commercial guy, don't buy residential equipment and expect it to last. And then come into my shop and expect warranty work on a $300 push mower you bought and now we're bitching that isn't working properly. Fucking clowns. If you mow commercially, get the commercial equipment, it's not going to break on you as fast. It's going to last longer. It was made for it. There's a reason it's pricier, because it's fucking better. One of the things about the machine that you're either going to love or you're going to hate is the front height adjustment. I personally think it's phenomenal. Not many parts to it. The more moving parts you have, the more things can break. So on these guys, I usually just lift it up with my toe. You pull up here, and the whole thing slides out. Pick your height, and then that's it. Other side. So real simple there. Back simple as well. And it's spring loaded, so it takes some of the weight. Just come up, come down. Makes it pretty simple. Operation wise, there's really not a whole lot to it. Kill switch, choke and throttle control, air filter, inline petcock, fuel filter there, oil filter. Everything's easily accessible for maintenance. Oil here. Flip it up and check out the bottom. These are timed blades. So if you take your blades off to sharpen them, make sure you put them back on the right way, or else they're going to hit in the middle, get destroyed, and you're going to be out even more money. See in the back there, transmission, pretty beefy, will last you a long time. Just like residential, back comes off pretty easily. The mulch plug, side discharge chute, a little too close to a muffler. It's all pretty easily done. This spring here, that's the mulch cover right there.
Joe, shoot.
See how she does with the backer. So we just did it at 3 inches and drop it down to 1 inch or so, see how she does. Considering it was lowest setting and you know, they don't take great care of this area behind the house, you can see what I was going through there. Did a pretty good job, definitely bogged down back here in this real, real thick shit. But I mean, that is a small Kawasaki engine. The big benefit of having that guy is though it's real fuel efficient. You know, that's a 1 gallon tank on it. You can run pretty much all day just off that 1 gallon. You just fill it up once and you can go all day. You know, not bad. That was with the side discharge. I mean, you can see it definitely isn't the prettiest, but if you're cutting grass that tall and you're just side discharging, it's not going to be pretty. It's just going to get cut.
All right, so that was it. The Commercial 30. Have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. I'll get back to you. If you want to see any specific piece of equipment reviewed or gone over, let me know and I'll see if I can get my hands on it. As always, have a good one, humans.